labour-intensive process down here. Every single barrel gets tested and tasted. This happens every 2 weeks. Also, the barrels get stirred. They use a stainless implement with a chain at the bottom that stirs through all the wine. This is to lessen any sediment forming at the bottom of the barrels. Also, we lose a fair bit of wine to evaporation. You'll notice the barrels have green wine inside. You can see a fair bit of staining around the silica bud at the top there. That is from the evaporation loss. So every month, these barrels need to be topped up. They get topped up with exactly the same wine variety, right to the very top to avoid any oxidisation. Also, during the summer months, this shed is temperature controlled, around about 21 degrees Celsius. It's supposed to be cooler in here. And this is to lessen what we call the age of shed. We are only using our barrels 3 times here at Sandiford during the maturation. We call this a first oak use, a second oak use, and a third oak use. A wine that's maturing in the first oak, that's a nice new barrel. So that wine is absorbing really strong flavours from the French oak. The characteristics, they are toasty and honey, nutty, buttery, and creamy characteristics. American oak barrels are more renowned for their vanilla and coconut nuances. Quite different flavours coming from the different oaks. A third use barrel, with the wines we're currently producing, a third use barrel is only about 2 to 5 years old maximum. None of these barrels are older than 5 years. Once they get and have had their third use, they're not really emitting out much more flavour into our wines. That is when our winemaker decides not to. Very high turnover for such a short time, the amount of barrels that we use. We actually sell them off once they've had their third use. We sell them to the local distilleries in the area. They use their barrels for their bourbon and rum and whiskies. They're getting about 8 and 12 and 15 years longer out of the same barrels. They'll burn the insides out, they leave the wood all charred. This can be the flavour in their bourbons, or they actually shake them back to as many as possible. And that's how they're getting so much longer. Also, the nurseries take some from us. They do sell them to the public. We don't. We only get about $100 for the barrels when we sell them off. So we are actually recycling. You'll notice down here we've got two of our hogs fenced down there with a beautiful pine wooden tabletop on the top there. So we're recycling and creating tables for our functions and weddings and concerts. Viable for us to do that because we don't get much money for it. We, at any given time, we have around $2.5 million in French oak barrels, and that's without the wine inside. A barrel maker. Anyone know what they're called? Cooper.
Yay!
Yep, that name Cooper originated from France, a town named Cooperidge. We actually don't have any Coopers in Western Australia. There's some in Bundaberg on the east coast where they produce their own rum. You can actually watch them at work. The barrels today are still made completely by hand. There's no machinery used or fabrications. It's also currently a 7-year apprenticeship to become a cooper these days and a very highly paid.